on the set.
Oh no!
Someone please strike the vodka lounger.
We'll meet you.
Yeah, let's have some names, please, Raul.
You know, maybe we should call them. I'll let this go once, but next time, how many people do we have playing?
Okay, let's
Groovy, player one, how about typing in your name for us?
We're gonna have to shave that down and we can't run it there.
Very nice. Now, player two, let's have your name now.
The levels are a little low.
45 seconds.
Player three, I think you know the drill. Yo, one more thing. You looking for a 21-question game or more like a 7-question tournament game?
Right. It's okay. Just don't do it.
All over it.
30 seconds.
Player one, your buzzer is the letter Q, as in qualm. Player two, your buzzer is the letter B, as in backfield in motion. Player three, your P, as in pagan.
Pull up the boom about 5
hey,
inches. It looks like it's going to be in frame.
Hey, 20 seconds. How's it going?
Hurry up, that's 20.
Oh, these are the greasy.
Alrighty, heads up. Here's how the game works. First one of you to buzz in on a question gets first stab at the answer. So you buzz in, and then press 1, 2, 3, or 4, depending on which answer you want. Real easy. Got it?
10 seconds.
Hey, good luck.
9. 8.
Okay, get the desktop
seven,
out of here.
And
6. Go to black.
5.
All right,
4,
have a good one, everybody.
Medieval tech action figures. They're not dolls!
It's time for the show where high culture and pop culture collide.
Welcome, you three. I want to remind you to use only a number 2 pencil and no fair peeking at the other players' tests. Got it? I want you to remember something. No matter what happens out there, I love each of you as much as I love any total strangers. Okay, here we go. Okay, first off, gotta give you your screws. Listen up. Say the question comes up and your neighbor gets that Mount Rushmore look on their face like they don't know what's going on. It's a perfect time to buzz in, hit the S key, and screw them. Then they gotta answer. Got it? Anyway, can we go now? Layer 3, what looks good to you? Well, looks like this category is...
Must reach utility belt.
$2,000 for a correct answer. Put it in gear, cause here we go. After defeating Mr. Freeze, suppose Batman and Robin had to take on Mr. Freeze. What tool would probably help them the most in their struggle? A bat chisel and bat hammer, a bat pillow and bat blanket, a bat pencil and bat paper, or some bat self-confidence? Layer 2, it's yours. A frieze is a type of decorative wall sculpture.
Take that, Mr. Freeze.
What do you think, Robin?
Holy Michelangelo, Batman! You've turned Mr. Freeze into Mr. Freeze's standing pile of rubble!
I wonder what player 2's gonna pick. Coming at you, the one-hit wonder of birth. Looks like this one's going for $1,000. Okay, imagine this. Your new baby picks up the phone to say his first words and to request the song Too Shy on the radio at the same time. What words did he utter? The Go-Go's, Kaja Goo Goo, Aha, or Bow Wow Wow? Take a shot, player two. Player two, who's getting it? Dance music, please. Player three's getting screwed. What's the answer, player three? Too Shy was by 80s flash in the pan, Kaja Goo Goo. You know, that's what I hate about baby radio. It's so formulaic. Nice work, player two. You just screwed yourself. Player three, you make the call. The selection is Don't Cry For Me, Oklahoma. $3,000 for this one. Let's see if you can wrap your head around this. If the band Tears for Fears toured along the same route as the Trail of Tears, who would be the most appropriate opening act? Alabama, the Atlanta Rhythm Section, Chicago, or Boston? Player three, do it. The Trail of Tears started in Georgia, where 15,000 Cherokee Indians were forced to leave in 1838. The Trail of Tears ended in Oklahoma, so Tears for Fears will have to either find a decent rock band from Oklahoma or follow some cheesy musical. Player three, give me some category.
You can't stop at three, no, you gotta have four, yeah!
The category is Fatal Subtraction, and you pocket 2,000 bucks if you get this one. You know the old saying, close only counts in horseshoes, hugging, and hand grenades? Well, based on her resume, you could say Glenn Close only counts in which of these films? Heartburn, Husbands and Wives, Hamlet, or Hooper? Player one, who you want to screw? Player three, don't take that. Give us an answer. Yeah, I got your heartburn. Player one, player two, go get it. Here's what you should have picked. The only one of these movies that Glenn Close appears in is Hamlet playing Mel Gibson's mother. Given their 9-year age difference, that must have been a pretty difficult childbirth. Player one, give me category.
Let's blow this time and head for number 5.
Well, what do we have here? Ooh, that sounds spooky. This one can net you a grand. Okay, open up your ears and get ready. All right, I need a bodily noise for a television theme song. Which of these sounds has already been used in the theme song of a horror comedy sitcom? Is it one, two, three, or four? And I'll play them one more time. One, two, three, or four. Player one. This finger-snapping noise was used in the theme song for The Addams Family, which was a sitcom about a family of monsters. Not to be confused with The Munsters, which had no snaps and was a completely different sitcom about a family of monsters. Player one, hit me with the category. This one likes to go by, or gunfire might work, and it's worth $2,000 if you get this one right. Think fast. Given the meaning of whelk, which of the following would have been the best way to end the Lawrence Welk show? With an explosion, with a long fade out, with a cattle stampede, or underwater? Player three, make it happen. Player three, who would you like to screw today? Gotta answer it, player two.
No.
Player one, player three, who wants it? Hey, got a minute? Take a look at a right answer. To whelk means to wither, wane, or otherwise fade away. And I guess Mr. Welk's show did fade away, especially when he died. Player two, give me something.
Seven, lucky, lucky seven.
For your enjoyment, the sounds of psychosis. This one's worth a grand. Heads up, here it comes. You're suffering from an irrational fear of 80s duos with bad shaves. What is the most likely term for your phobia? The Nelson Willies, the Wim Whams, the Heebie-Bee-Gees, or the Vapors? See, now, I could have given you some cash if you pick this. Wham! Two smirking guys with defective razors. Another symptom of the Whim-Whams is bedwetting, the failure to wake up before you go-go. Category time. Player two, it's your call. Uh-oh, Elmer Fudd Dime Store.
It's time for a Clear-ish Crash Fund.
Let's see if you can make sense of this gibberish category. Kill Fran and call Sonny Bono's ex-wife. Let's get the ball rolling at 5K for this gibberish question. Alright, as soon as you know the answer, buzz in, because I'm taking away some cash every second and a half. Okay, when you can tell me what catchphrase this rhymes with, just buzz in and start typing. Martyr Nanny, have her wedge share, and don't be fooled. Yeah, let's see what you've got, player one. Type in your answer and hit return. Yeah, man, I heard Yogi got a combined 1,600 on his SATs. Player one, tell me what's happening.
Aloha, question number 9.
And I believe this one's called Webster Would Be Proud, we think. $2,000 says you don't know this one. Well, look what we've got here. Today's a special treat. Today we've got a real celebrity in the studio to help host this question. Let's bring him in here, Raul, and tell him who we've got.
Yeah, okay. Today we've got Jeffrey Dincher, who has memorized the entire Webster's Third New International Dictionary.
Great. Hi, Jeff.
Hi, Cookie.
How you doing? You excited?
Oh, yes. I'm innervated.
Ooh, that must hurt. So you've memorized the entire dictionary, huh?
Indubitably.
How long did that take you?
About 4 years.
Okay, well, let's see that question then.
Okay. Of these four, which word's entry appears last in the dictionary? Is it proopic, propagate, proliferate, or propaganda?
All yours, player one.
Propagate, meaning to cause to continue or increase by natural reproduction. You know, like to have kids. It's the last entry of these four in the dictionary.
That was great, Jeff. That's some talent you've got.
Thanks, Cookie. Will you be my friend?
Sure, Jeff. But after the show, okay? All right, then. Well, we've all learned a new word, and I've got a new friend. Let's move on now.
Thanks, Cookie.
Yeah, bye. Bye, Jeff. There's the door. Let's have a category, player one. Oh, you're so naughty. You just picked a three-way. Okay, this is simple, but hear me out anyway. You're gonna see a three-way like this one. Buzz in when the correct three-way member is lit up and you score. But be wary, it'll cost you $1,000 every time you buzz in and you're wrong. But don't be misled, this question may or may not have anything to do with the three-way as a group. So, let's get it on. Let's just say this one's known as, what do you want, a medal? Or do you just want a three-way? Well, here it is. Gold, silver, or bronze. Here we go. And for goodness sake, be careful.
Oh, yes! Oh, yes! Oh, yes! Oh, yes! Oh, yes! Oh, yes! Oh, yes!
And it looks like we're all done. Let's check out your performance. Player three, not too shabby. You seem to rack them up nicely there. Let's see how this affects the overall standings. Well, seems to me player one is still whipping some tail in this game. Yes, it's time to move on now, but I'll never forget our special experience together. Whatever your name is. Okay, either you finished round one, or you have another round to go. You know, depending on how you look at these things. Okay, whether you like it or not, everyone here gets a screw. What you do with it is up to you. One apiece. Every question in round two is worth twice as much, so we got some serious cash at stake here. Let's get to it. Player three, time to make a decision. Shake hands with. The Pope got a ring in his cracker jack. You get 4,000 clams for this one. Hey, you know how it's a sign of respect when someone kisses that big old ring the Pope wears? Well, imagine that the Pope owned a mood ring. So, take a look and tell me. What mood is the Pope in? Anxious, sensitive, tense, or happy? Let's take a look at the right answer. From what I can see, the Pope's mood ring is bright blue. That means he's pretty happy today. And why not? He's got a cool hat and a nice ride. He's styling. Your pick, player two. How about it?
I'm getting a rating of 12.
This one's called Nice Knockers, Baby. Play your cards right, you win 4,000 bucks. Time to fill in the blank. Buzz in and start typing when you know the answer. Knock, knock. Take it away, player three. Type in your answer and hit return. The proper response to knock, knock is always, who's there? Unless, of course, you think it's the Jehovah's Witnesses and you pretend you're not home. Player three, tell me what's on your mind. Pucker up for occupational hazards of fictional people. 4,000 big ones for a right answer here. Put your tray in the upright position. It's time for takeoff. Which TV character's occupation requires him to deal most directly with the zoning improvement plan instituted in 1963? Barney Miller, Cliff Clavin, Perry Mason, or Tim Taylor? Up to you, player three. Cliff, the mailman from Cheers, works most directly with the zoning improvement plan because that, my little mail sacks, is where zip codes come from. All I can say is thank goodness he's getting drunk at Cheers all the time. I'd hate to be surprised by mail actually arriving on time. Your call, player three.
Ain't no love like number 14.
Let's see what we got going. Hey, that's not chicken. Get a right answer. You're walking away with $4,000. Okay, listen up. Let's imagine this conversation between Hawkeye Pierce and Dr. Sidney Friedman from MASH. It's driving me crazy, Sidney. I hate the idea of war, but I'm committed to fixing these kids so they can go back and fight the war. How would Dr. Sidney Friedman most likely respond? I'm intrigued by your cognitive dissonance. Do you dream of sleeping with your father? You have a vast collective unconscious, or, geez, you're worse than Narcissus. Layer two, grab it! Cognitive dissonance is the tension caused by holding two conflicting beliefs, like being opposed to war yet patching up soldiers so they can return to battle. Or say, being a dark satirical movie adapted for primetime television. Player two, take your pick.
Not 14, not 16, you're right in between.
May I introduce Bears, Bulls, and Balls. How does $2,000 sound? Man, is it me or can you see almost any kind of sport on some of those cable sports networks? If you turned on ESPN2 and saw a bunch of guys known to regulate stock trading playing basketball against colleges like Alabama and Georgia, what would you be watching? The ACC playing in the ACC, the WAC playing in the WAC, the SEC playing in the SEC, or the PYT playing in the PYT? Layer 3, make it happen. The Securities and Exchange Commission regulates trading on the stock market, and the Southeastern Conference is a college conference in the NCAA. I keep getting confused over whether the referee is signaling a jump ball or a junk bond. It's all about you, player three. Which one do you want? Excellent choice, Player 3. Warm up your fingers while Players 1 and 2 get out of the way, because it's your turn to play Diss or Dat. This Diss or Dat's category name is Uma Oprah. I'm going to read off seven names, and for each one, I want you to tell me if it's a person with the last name Zappa or the last name Phoenix. As each comes up, if it's someone with the last name Zappa, press 1. If it's someone with the last name Phoenix, press 2. And press 4 if you want to skip. Each correct answer will net you 1,000 bucks. And you lose 1,000 if you get it wrong or if you don't get to it at all. Okay, give me 30 seconds on the clock. And we're off. Liberty, Zappa Kid or Phoenix Kid? Moon Unit. Joaquin. Summer. Rain. Ahmed. This is it. Weasel. That's all she wrote. You dropped a couple, but I've seen worse. Let's check out your total. Okay, I need three more categories. Hit me. Your turn, Player 2. What's it gonna be?
On the big bayou in Louisiana, quest on 17.
Here we have Frat Boys from Outer Space. And get this one right, you got 4K coming your way. Okay, let's say the planets of the solar system have a beer bash and start disturbing the peace. Because it has no natural satellites, which of these planets would not be able to moon a passing comet? Saturn, Mercury, Uranus, or Mars? Player 1. Mercury has no moons. They only let him into the party because he agreed to the panty raid on Venus. Player 1, your choice. What are we doing? Boy, now it's time for some real trivia. You've got an impossible question coming your way. The category? Math and haberdashers. And let's see, this one's only worth $20,000. Now, you may never have thought that Alice in Wonderland's Mad Hatter and Hee Haw's Minnie Pearl had a damn thing in common, but guess again. If you subtract the number on the Mad Hatter's hat from the number on Minnie Pearl's hat, what would the equation look like? And I'll just let you read the choices yourself. Player 2, it's yours. Minnie Pearl wore a price tag on her hat that read $1.98. The Mad Hatter's hat has a note on it that reads, in this style, 10/6. And the difference is 0.31. Hey, congratulations on getting it right. You might want to take some Advil now to bring the swelling down. You have the honors, Player 2. This category is known as the White House of Ill Repute. How does $4,000 grab you? Just step up and take a swing at this one. In the American President, Michael Douglas plays a widowed chief of state. If the movie were based on a true bachelor president, what might co-star Annette Bening have said to him? Let's talk perfect union, Mr. Lincoln. So, show me why they call you Harding. Forget the South. Hold me, Mr. Buchanan. Or how about a poke? Oak. Player 1, hit it. Our 15th president, James Buchanan, was a bachelor. Of course, he didn't have Annette Bening around to tempt him. Player 1, ante up. Now serving, I'll reincarnate for you. Get it right, I'm handing over 2K. Hey, remember Culture Club's music video for Karma Chameleon? It's set in the 1800s on the Mississippi where the boys are causing trouble on a steamboat. If Culture Club had shot its video for Karma Chameleon on a sacred Hindu river, which image might you now see? Michael Craig plucking a koto on the Yangtze? Boy George doing the hora on the Jordan? John Moss banging a bongo on the Congo? Or Roy Hayes strumming a sitar on the Ganges? All yours, Player 1.
karma is a central concept of Hinduism, and the Ganges is a sacred Hindu river. As far as karma goes, do you think Culture Club will be considered a good act or a bad act in determining Boy George's station in his next life? Player one, it's up to you. What's next?
You're about to embark on the attack. Hit your buzzer when you see two words on the screen that match. 2,000 bucks if you're right, 2,000 off if you're wrong. It's not so hard as long as you remember this.
Remember the clue.
It's gotta be a match that fits this clue. Where did that come from? And where are you going? Time to find out right now.
You never used that nose hair clipper you got for your birthday last year. Either way, you can breathe a lot easier knowing.
You don't know, Jack!
Great show, everybody. Lovely work as usual. Rahul Han, what's going on now?
If you think you'd like to play another game, just let me know. I'll be right over here eating a sandwich.
I'm afraid he died at school this morning.
What? Timmy?
Yeah, he died of a severe wedgie.
He's so bad.
Yeah, the autopsy show he also suffered from repeated wet willies.
What? Who is this?
Who?
Looks like little Timmy's mother's a bit pissed.
Pissed? I'm the one who should be pissed. You wouldn't let me finish the joke.
Oh, you guys are so crazy.
109.7 WEOB. The Asylum. Weekday mornings from 7 to 11.
This week on Zenora, Queen of Battle, a city is under siege.
Ah, battle makes me so tense.
Here, let me rub your shoulders.
And hope is running out.
Ugh, my breastplate is stuck.
Here, Zenora, let me help you.
All on the next Zenora.
You've seen the video of the alien autopsy and you say you still don't believe? Well, here's the video the government really doesn't want you to see. Alien routine checkup. Let's listen to the hearing test.
Right? Left? Right?
You're probably asking yourself, is it real or is it faux? Would a fake doctor do this?
Okay now, Mr. Alien, turn your head.
Doctor, those aren't my testicles. These are my testicles.
Due to the graphic nature of this video, we recommend you don't watch it alone.
Okay, now, Mr. Alien, I need you to bend
I wouldn't
over.
Do that, Doctor. Okay, I tend to clamp up.
Order before midnight tonight and get a free bonus tape. Aliens, funniest home video.
Oh, I should be able to sink this putt as long as I avoid the pond. Oh, help! Your water burns my scaly alien skin!
Wasn't that a riot? Order now, before you come to your senses.
Johnson, that presentation was awful. I want to see you in my office, pronto.
I don't get it, Phil. My thinking on that presentation was sound.
Your thinking was sound? It's your hair.
My hair?
It looks like you combed it with a fried chicken leg.
I can't help it. It's my overactive sebaceous glands.
Don't worry. There's help. Have you heard of Squirt 2000?
Squirt 2000?
It's a shampoo, conditioner, body wash, and moisturizer all in one.
Sounds good, but the boss wants to see me right now.
Here, use mine.
You carry a bottle on you?
Well, Squirt 2000 is also a refreshing sports drink.
I'll be in the bathroom.
Hey, Johnson, how'd the meeting with the boss go?
I think it went okay.
Hey, Johnson, I like the way you think.
Thanks, sir.
But more importantly, I like your hair.
Squirt 2000, when you really need nice hair. We're an Arthur Daniels Heartland company. We make the Illuminati look like Cub Scouts.
Trucks love dogs.
This week on Zenora, Queen of Battle, a journey is undertaken.
Here, Janelle, we can bathe in this hot spring.
And there's room for both of us.
And Janelle is wounded.
Ow! My inner thigh!
Here, let me rub some ointment on that.
All on the next Zenora.
Good lunch, Mom.
Oops. Billy, your milk! Look out! Oh, Billy.
Out of my way, you old bag.
Who are you, and what are you doing in my house?
I'm the brazen paper towel man, and I'm here to clean up that spill, unless you'd rather use that wimpy, sorry-ass paper towel you usually use.
Well, how good is brazen?
How good is brazen? Shut your trap, and I'll tell you.
Hey, you can't talk to my mom like that!
Shut up, punk, or I'll smack you on the back of the head with my class ring. Brazen paper towels eat spills for breakfast. One single sheet of brazen will sop up a small, scummy pond. See that milk?
Yes.
Well, watch this, baby.
What was that scream?
That was the milk, begging for mercy.
Brazen paper towels. We're an Arthur Daniels Heartland company, but you don't need to know that.